Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Please, let's close our eyes. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you. We give you praise. We honor your name. You are the Almighty God. We thank you because you are the giver of life. You are the keeper of life. You are the preserver of life. We bless your majesty, O Lord, for your hand of mercy upon our lives. Thank you, Jehovah God, for favor. Thank you for goodness. Thank you for all the great things that you are doing in our lives. We thank you for the life you are giving unto us. Father, accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Father, I pray, O Lord, this day, O Lord, lay your mighty hand upon us in the name of Jesus. Thank you, wonderful Father, for what you have been doing, O Lord, on this platform, Moment of Victory. To you alone be the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Praise the name of the Lord. This is Moment of Victory, and I pray for you that God will give you victory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I want us to do some prayers before you check the scripture tonight together. And I want you to pray this prayer very well. Say, O God of peace, visit every department of my life in the name of Jesus Christ. You need peace in your life. You need peace in every department of your life. You need peace in your marriage. You need peace in your business. You need peace in your family. You need peace in your neighborhood. You need peace in your state. You need peace in your state. You need peace in your country. You need peace anywhere you may find yourself. You need peace. Ask the Lord to visit every department of your life with peace. You are God of peace, O Lord. Visit me, O Lord, with your peace, O Lord. Visit every department of my life with peace in the name of Jesus Christ. I receive peace of mind in the name of Jesus Christ. I receive peace, O Lord, in this world, O Lord, in this strange world. I receive peace, O God, in the name of Jesus. The peace of God that passes all understanding. Enter into my life now in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Say, Holy Ghost fire, purge me and make me clean for your glory in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, purge me and make me clean for your glory. Purge me and make me clean for your glory. Holy Ghost fire, purge me and make me clean. 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 Holy Ghost fire, purge me, make me clean. Purge me, make me clean. Holy Ghost fire, purge me, make me clean. Purge me, make me clean. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Say, powers assigned to render me unfit for divine promotion. Say, powers assigned to render me unfit for divine promotion. Die in the name of Jesus Christ. Power assigned to render me unfit for divine promotion. Die in the name of Jesus Christ. Power assigned to render me unfit for divine promotion. Die in the name of Jesus. Power assigned to render me unfit for divine promotion. Die in the name of Jesus. Power assigned to render me unfit for divine promotion. Die in the name of Jesus Christ. Die in the name of Jesus Christ. Powers assigned to render me unfit for divine promotion. Die in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Say, powers assigned to render me unfit for divine lifting. Die in the name of Jesus. Power assigned to render me unfit for divine lifting. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, O Lord, lift up my head. Lord, lift up my head. Baba, lift up my head. Let us begin to pray that prayer. Oh Lord, lift up my head. Lift up my head, oh Lord. Lift up my head, oh Lord. I need divine lifting. Lift up my head, oh Lord. Lift up my head, oh Lord. Lift up my head, oh Lord. Lift up my head. Lift up my head in Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. So shall it be. In the name of Jesus, I cover you with the blood of Jesus Christ. I pray that the Lord will give you divine illumination concerning what we discussed today in the name of Jesus Christ. Your life will never remain the same. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. So, for this short period, I want to be talking on this title, Engaging Your Divine Status for Victorious Living. Engaging Your Divine Status for Victorious Living. Engaging Your Divine Status for Victorious Living. And this one will take us to the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 43. I read from verse 1. I'm going to read verse 1, verse 3, verse 7, and 21. Isaiah 43, verse 1. Look at it. But now, thus said the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and ye that form thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee, I have called thee by thy name, thou art mine. You belong to God. The hand of God is upon your life. Yes, you belong to him. Look at it. Thou art mine. This is God. Verse 3. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for thee. Your God is the Almighty. Look at verse 7. Even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. Look at verse 21. These people have I formed for myself. They shall show forth my praise. Divine status. Thank you, Jesus. Look at 1 Corinthians chapter 6. 1 Corinthians chapter 6. Let's look at something else there. 1 Corinthians chapter 6. I want to read from verse 19. 1 Corinthians 6, 19. It reads, what? Know ye not that your body is the temple of Holy Ghost, which is in you, which you have of God, and ye are not your own? For ye are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. You are God's. Divine status, you are God. Look at Revelation chapter 5. Engaging your divine status for victorious living. You must know who you are. You must operate by that knowledge. It will really help you. Look at it, Revelation 5:19. And they sung a new song, saying, thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seal thereof, for thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by thy blood out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation, and hast made us unto our God kings and priests, and we shall reign on earth. And I beheld and heard the voice of many angels round about the throne, and the beasts and the elders, and the number of them was 10,000 times 10,000 and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing. Engaging your divine status for victorious living. Christianity is born into glory. Christianity is born into honor. Christianity is born into praise. Is born into dignity. Is born into royalty. Is born into grace. But it is very sad that many Christians live the opposite of what I just mentioned. Many people that should be living life of heaven on earth are completely earthbound. Many are living in deceit. Many are living in defeat. Many are living in failure, in shame, reproach, and in agony. It is so disheartening that many Christians in this dispensation are fake and living in denial, living below the standard of the Almighty. In many instances, all we see is the opposite of Christianity of our fathers in faith. The powerlessness of so-called people is so huge that he has confused the mind of young believers that are coming up. We need to get back on the track. We need to live our divine status now. I repeat, we need to live our divine status now if there are going to be any change at all in this our generation. What is your divine status? Your root is in Christ, the anointed. That is, you are rooted in the anointing of Jesus Christ. The one that is born of flesh is flesh. The one that is born of spirit is spirit. So you are born of the spirit. Your root is in the anointed, Jesus Christ. What is your divine status? You have the status of royalty, glory, and praise. Royalty, glory, and praise. We are made unto our God as kings and priests. You are a prophet of God. You're supposed to be a prophet to yourself, to yourself. You're supposed to be a prophet to your own destiny. You are a prophet. You are a prophetess. That is your divine status. You are called royal priesthood, chosen generation, and an only person. You are born to show forth the praise and glory of God on earth. The big question is this: when are you going to start living this glorious status of yours? When are you going to live holy Christian life? When are you going to live victorious life? You are born into victory, and I encourage you today, start now. Start now. How do you engage your divine status for victorious living? I will tell you before we go, by the grace of God, purge yourself from vileness of flesh and the spirit. Purge yourself. Do it on your own. Be conscious of it. Practice it. Exercise into godliness. Exercise into righteousness. Exercise into holiness. Purge yourself from vileness of the mind. Purge yourself the vileness of the flesh. Purge yourself from the vileness of your mind. Take practical steps to live holy life. Shun all avenues of sinful habits for you to recover your divine status. Search for more of God in all your dealings. Let God take the preeminence. Let God be your priority. Let God be your number one, number two, number three, and number last. Let Holy Spirit direct your life. Give the totality of your being to the control of the Holy Spirit. I repeat, let the Holy Spirit direct your life. Give the totality of your being to the control of the Spirit of God. Then be sensitive to the prompting of the Holy Spirit. Don't live casual life. Don't live anyhow. Some are just on their own. They are living alone. They are living apart from the dictation of the Holy Spirit. They are not hearing any voice. They are not hearing any instruction. He's not talking to them. They are not talking to them. And they are not bothered. And you still carry the Bible. And the owner of the Bible, the author of the Bible, is not in our lives. So you need to be sensitive to the prompting of the Holy Spirit. Give God the first priority in your life, including your business, including your dealing, including your profession. Be active in your inner man. Be a good person. Be active. Be a good person. See and believe what the word of God calls you. You must believe it. You must see it. You must activate it. You must live it. You must behave it. Behave what God calls you. Behave what the Spirit of God and the Scripture, what He calls you, behave it. Then start living your status by abiding in Christ in all things. Abide in Christ in all things. Look at John chapter 15. John chapter 15. Look at it from verse 4. John 15, 4. Abide in me. This is Jesus speaking. And I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye, except ye abide in me. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit, for without me ye can do nothing. So the shining of your glory is in abiding in Christ. You can only find fulfillment in Christ if you abide in him. I pray God will empower you to regain your colorful status in Christ for victorious living in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Please abide in Christ for you to recover, for you to regain your status, for full restoration of your divine status. I pray as from this moment you begin to live your divine status, and all the elements of nature, they will bow to you in the name of Jesus. You will rule, you will reign, you will be in charge, you will overcome all situations and circumstances, you will dominate situation in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will be in charge in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Witches and wizards, when they see you, they will run away in the name of Jesus. When they gather against you, they will scatter in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Any power that sending evil arrow to you will backfire unto them. They will know that you're a child of God. The Lord will fight your battle. You will hold your peace in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. No evil will befall you in Jesus' name. I'd like you to close your eyes and say like this: Oh Lord, let my change appear now, appear by fire. In the name of Jesus Christ, I need a change, O Lord. Let my change appear now. Appear by fire, appear by fire. Let my change appear by fire. Let my change appear by fire. Let my change appear by fire. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, my divine original, hear the word of the Lord. Appear and lift my destiny up in the name of Jesus Christ. My divine original, hear the word of the Lord. Appear and lift my destiny up. Lift my destiny up. Lift it up. Lift it up. Lift it up now in the name of Jesus. My divine original, appear right now. Appear. I hear the word of the Lord. Appear. Yes, Lord. And lift my destiny up in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, every invisible enemy frustrating my divine status in Christ, crash in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every invisible enemy frustrating my divine status in Christ, crash now, crash in the name of Jesus, crash in the name of Jesus, crash in the name of Jesus, crash in the name of Jesus. Every invisible enemy frustrating my divine status in Christ, crash, 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 in Jesus. Then we pray. Say, I declare loud and clear. Say, I declare loud and clear, my purpose in life shall not be disgraced in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare loud and clear, my purpose in life shall not be disgraced in the name of Jesus. I decree loud and clear, and I declare loud and clear, my purpose in life shall not be disgraced in Jesus' name we pray. Say, battles terrorizing my divine power, scatter in the name of Jesus Christ. Battle terrorizing my divine power, scatter in the name of Jesus. Scatter in the name of Jesus. Battles terrorizing my divine power, scatter in the name of Jesus. Scatter in the name of Jesus. Scatter in the mighty name of Jesus. Scatter in Jesus' name we pray. Say, every law of darkness fighting my star, break into pieces now in the name of Jesus Christ. Every law of darkness fighting my star, break into pieces now, 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 in Jesus' name we pray. Say, glory of the living God, overshadow my life now in the name of Jesus. Glory of the living God, overshadow my life, 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 overshadow my life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. I cover you with the grace of God and the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And I pray, O Lord, you will regain your divine status. You will live in it. You shall be well with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Cover you with the precious blood of Jesus. Thank you, wonderful Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. This is moment of victory. And I pray that God will continue to give you victory. And don't forget, every moment of resistance to temptation is a victory. Never, never give up. Thank you. God bless you. And bye-bye.